BBC Radio Stoke.
Were you in the Scouts years ago? And if you were, you may have fond memories of campfires and learning skills like cooking, map reading, possibly even tying knots. Well, this weekend, hundreds of them have joined together for an international themed conference and camp. Some of the activities are the same, but they also have a colour run, it's a knockout, and they're also trying to break a world record. Well, to find out more, we can speak to Dot Bailey, the Assistant Commissioner for Youth Development, and also Jasmine, who's on the camp. Morning to you, and first of all, Dot, how are things going so far, and what have you been up to?
Good morning, and yeah, things are going really well. We've got over 500 young people at Kibbleston enjoying themselves on this international theme camp. We did a wide game last night. We opened the camp and then we did a wide game last night where the young people had to go and find pieces of a jigsaw, bring them back, make the jigsaw up and find a coordinate.
So
to get the prize.
It's an international theme camp. So what does that mean and how does it work?
Okay, so what we've done is there's a jamboree coming up, a World Scout Jamboree, the 24th in North America. We've got young people going there next week, six young people from Newcastle-under-Lyme district. So what we wanted to do was sort of help with the preparation and the run-up to that and let the other scouts that aren't going there have a taste of what an international camp's all about. So we've given each group that are on camp, there's 14 of them, a country to represent. So they are going to, they've got costumes and activities relative to that country, and they're going to share those throughout the weekend.
Okay, so also there's a record-breaking attempt going on that you're planning as well, isn't there?
There is, yes. On Sunday morning, we're going to attempt to make the biggest human fleur-de-lis, which is the Scout emblem. So it stands at the moment, I believe, at about 440 people. So as we've got 550 on camp, we're hoping to smash that. We've got a drone coming. We've got to have independent witnesses that for the Guinness Book of Records standards. So that's what we're attempting on Sunday morning.
That must have taken quite a bit of planning, mustn't it?
Yeah, it's been months in the planning, but it seems to be coming together.
Now, I know that you also have Jasmine with you, is that right?
That's right, yeah.
Do you want to hand over to Jasmine?
I will do, yeah.
Hi, Jasmine.
Hi.
Hi. So what's your role? What have you been doing this weekend then? What have you been doing?
This weekend, I've been a young leader, so I've been helping out with my scout group and I help about around the camp.
Right, OK. So are you involved with the record-breaking attempt as well?
Yes, I am.
So what's your role in that?
Basically, our scout group's going to come over tomorrow morning and Dot and Paul and everyone else is going to direct us to where we need to go.
Hmm. So I know that the jamboree is happening. Is it next week, is it, the jamboree?
Yes.
Are you going off there?
Yeah.
Okay, tell us all about it. So where is it? And you must be very excited about it. Tell us where it is, just remind us.
It's in West Virginia.
Okay, have you been to the United States before?
No, I've never been before.
Okay, so it must have taken some planning and some saving. And so how did you manage to get the money to go?
So I've been fundraising by doing bad packs, bake sales, car washes, and then I decided to do a fundraise walk up Snowdon twice.
Great. And how long is it? Does it last at the Jamboree?
The Jamboree's 10 days, but we get to go other places in the States.
Mm. So what sort of things do you do? Because it isn't just going to a camp, is it, and sort of camping for 10 days. What else do you do?
We can help out around the area, so like litter picking. Also, we can do scuba diving, climbing, paintballing, archery, and whitewater rafting.
Sounds great. Do you want to hand back to Dot for me, please?
Yeah.
Okay, that's Jasmine. Hi, Dot.
Hi.
Hello. It sounds exciting going off to the Jamboree. In terms of development, though, it must be an important part of the Scout movement, is it?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, that's one of the basics of the Scout movement is to teach people skills for life, young people skills for life, and hopefully when they've been on an experience like that goes a long way to doing that.
So Jasmine is going. How many others are going from this area?
We've got five more from Newcastle-under-Lyme district, so there's six young people between 14 and 18 that are very excited at the minute and ready to go next Saturday.
And I think you said earlier or suggested that they're not regular events, jamborees. They just happen very very rarely. So from a point of view of the jamboree itself, what is the sort of the main meaning behind it? Is getting cultures and different languages and different people together?
Yeah, I mean, it's a meeting of scouts from across the world. It happens every 4 years and it's in a different country each year, each time. And this year, there's over 40,000 young people attending the Jamboree, and that is 152 countries represented, which is mammoth.
Wow. Are you going?
I'm not, no. Unfortunately, no. I'm a little bit too old.
Right. Well, Dot, thanks for talking to us today, and good luck to those that are going to the United States. And they set off tomorrow, isn't it? Tomorrow?
No, next Saturday.
Next Saturday.
Yeah.
Brilliant. All right. Thanks for talking to us.
Okay, bye. No problem. Bye. Thank you. Bye.